in my oral history interest in my own presentation, but what struck me about the similarities or connections for me in your three presentations, and even before you started specifically talking about citizenship, was how citizenship literature parallels a lot of the discussion. And Carolyn, when you started off looking at the use of the word genocide and how it's used differently, it immediately resonated with me of all the critiques of how the word citizenship is used differently. And Linda Bosniak has written a piece on how citizenship can be thought of as a legal status, and as you discussed it, but also in terms of rights activity as political participation as identity. And then in her piece, which I use in my teaching of citizenship to sort of unpack it with law, she looks at the way that in all of the contexts, citizenship has a sort of an appraisive, normative, positive value. And so it's that connection to that value that makes it a useful term. So I was thinking from that perspective of the continued and different uses or contested uses of genocide, whether there's something that is a parallel with that. And then from that notion of active citizenship, in some ways the lawyers, and this will link into my oral history later, the lawyers are acting as active citizens. So it's not about citizenship as formal status, although that is what you're actually active in. But in any sort of context, whether it was the legal aid lawyers in the context of your research, these are all different frames within which the place of law in society has such strong constitutive value that active participation by lawyers becomes a central frame for thinking about citizenship in practice. So I was just thinking that there are some interesting things there that we can convey to a little more.